In this lecture, we would like to discuss about a PN junction. We can call it simply as a semiconductor junction. So let's see what happens if we take two pieces of a semiconductor, for example silicon, with different doping properties and put them together to make a junction. So let's start out with what is called a PN junction, in which we have p-type silicon on one side of this boundary and n-type silicon on the other side of the boundary. So here we can call it, this is the boundary between these two semiconductors, or we can also call it as a junction. In a PN junction, one side there is a p-type semiconductor and other side there is a n-type semiconductor. And let me write very important point regarding this junction. It is worth to note that practically it is not possible to put together two separate pieces of crystals and have them in uniform contact on an atomic scale. Instead, junctions are made out of a single crystal which has been modified in the two separate regions one way is to add some suitable doping impurity to the melt after only half of the crystal has grown. So it's very important to note that we can't make a contact between two separate crystals to make this junction. For this, normally we grow half of the crystal with, let's say, with p-type or adding some acceptor impurity in this, and after growing half, then we add n-type impurity in the melt. That is when the crystal is in its growing stage. So then after we add some donor impurities, so that our half of the crystal can get p-type property and other half of the crystal can get n-type properties. So in this way we make a junction, and it's very important point to note that. And another main point here is that normally junctions do not have a sharp boundary. Sharp boundary. But for our discussion, we will imagine an ideal situation in which these two regions of the crystal with different properties meeting at a sharp boundary. Meaning here is that when we make a p-type and n-type junction, normally we make such type of a boundary. That is here p-side and here n-side. So we think that this boundary is sharp, that is n type is starting from where the p type is ending, but normally this boundary is not sharp. Sometime it's like this, that's some, it may be like this, that is p type is ending in a different region and from where n-type is starting. So normally this boundary between p-type and n-type region is not sharp, but for our discussion here we are assuming that this boundary is sharp. So this is very important point that can be noted. And we know that on the n side, of the PN junction, there are free electrons which can move about as well as the fixed donor sites. Which balance the overall electric charge. So in N side, we know that there are free electrons and these electrons can move in the entire region, and with these electrons there are ionized donor atoms with positive charges. We can draw these charges like this. And we know that these donor ions cannot move. So here I am so in this way, in n-type semiconductor, electrons are acting as majority carriers, and we know that there are few holes also in the n-type semiconductors due to thermal agitation. So we can make some holes here also. Let's say these are holes in the N region. So let me write here, that is this representing an electron. this plus sign representing a hole, and this plus sign in circle representing a donor. Ion, and on the other side of this junction, that is in the P side, there are free holes. And with these free holes, there are acceptor ions also. So let me draw these ions with a negative sign in the circle. Again, these acceptor ions like donor ions can't move in the crystal. So these ions are not taking part in the electrical conductivity. So overall, this region is electrically neutral, because here number of negative charges are equal to the number of positive charges, and similarly here P type region is also electrically neutral. So let me write here, that is on the P side of the junction, on the P side there are free holes, moving about and equal number of negative acceptor sites, that keeping the charge balanced. So therefore, in P side, holes are in majority, and it's also important to note that in P side, due to thermal agitation, there are some electrons also. So here we are having two holes. So similarly, we can make here two electrons in the P side. Here in N side, these holes are known as minority carriers, or acting like a minority carriers. And in a similar way, in P side, these electrons are acting as minority carriers. So now let's assume that P1, which is equal to P naught, is the number of holes in the P side, and P2, which is equal to P N naught, is the number of holes in the N side. So therefore, total number of holes in the system can be written as P, which is equal to P1 plus P2, and which is equal to P naught plus P N naught. And here it is very important to note that P naught is greater than the P N naught. So we can see that here in P side, number of holes is greater in number, and in N side, electrons are greater in number. So we can see that there is a concentration gradient, that is, in this side majority are holes, and N side electrons are in majority. So due to this concentration gradient, hole concentration, gradient, holes diffuse toward the N side. Similarly, electrons or electron concentration gradient with, similarly, we can write electrons as N, which is equal to N N naught, that is the number of electrons in the N side, plus N P naught, which is the number of electrons in the P side. Similarly, electron concentration gradient drive the electron by diffusion toward the P side. So we can See that hole diffusing and entering the N side recombine with the electrons. In the N side. Near the junction. Similarly, electrons that are diffusing and entering to the P side recombine with holes in the P side that are present near the junction. So, meaning here is that since there is concentration gradient on both sides, here we can see that holes are in great concentration. So these holes will try to diffuse in this side, and when these holes will diffuse and enter in the N side, these holes will recombine these electrons, and in a similar manner electrons due to concentration gradient electron will diffuse in the P side, and when these electrons will enter in the P side they will recombine with these holes. And consequently, the junction region becomes depleted of free charge carriers in comparison to or in comparison with the bulk P side and N side that is far away from the junction. So first let me copy that diagram. So here, due to this diffusion and recombination, there are depletion of the charge carrier near the junction, or we can, since due to entering of the electrons in p side, they will recombine with the holes. So we can erase these holes, and at the same time, due to diffusion, holes are entering in the n side, and they will recombining with these electrons. So we can remove these electrons. So in this way, this region, let me make it with this red color. So this region, we can say, is depleted from the charge carriers. So this region, and we can see as we go away from this region, there are free holes in the p side and free electrons in the n side. And we can see that, let me write here, that electrons leaving the n side near the junction leave behind exposed positively charged donor ions. So here we can see that since these electrons are recombined with the holes, so here we can see that these four donor ions with positive charges are exposed, or we can see this region now is not electrically neutral. And at the same time, we can see that here holes are recombined with the electrons. So this removal of holes are exposing these acceptor ions. So now this p side is also not electrically neutral. So in this way, we can get a positive charge on this side of the junction and negative charge on this side of the junction. And it's very important point that can be noted. So let me write this point here again for holes. Similarly, holes leaving the p side near the junction. Leave behind exposed negatively charged acceptor ions. So therefore, there is a depletion region or sometime it is also called as space charge layer. Around the junction. And due to this, diffusion of opposite charge carriers and exposing of the immobile charge carriers, there is an induced internal electric field we can write it as AD from N side to P side. So we can see that due to exposure of these positive ions in the N side and negative ions in the P side, there is an induced electric field which is acting from P side to N side is induced. So we can write this electric field as AD. So now this electric field tries to drift the holes back into the P side. And electrons back into the N side from the junction. So here again we can see that this D this electric field will try to oppose the movement of these holes in the p side and electrons in the n side. It is apparent that as more and more holes diffuse toward the junction, or toward the junction, the internal electric field around the junction will increase until eventually an equilibrium is reached. When the rate of holes diffusing toward the N side is just balanced by holes drifting back to the P side. That are driven by ED. The electron diffusion and drift fluxes will also be balanced in equilibrium. Meaning here is that as more and more charge carriers move in the opposite direction. This built-in electric field will also going to increase, and at a particular point this electric field will become so enough that can oppose the further diffusion of the charge carriers. So at that point there is no diffusion of the charge carrier across this junction. And one important thing is here is that the movements of the carriers due to concentration gradient is known as diffusion, but the movements of the charge carrier due to applied electric field or built-in electric field is known as the drifting or drift. So here charge carriers are drifting because of the electric field, and they are diffusing due to the concentration gradient. So here due to this separation of charge carriers there is also a built-in potential VB, built-in potential. VB. And now let me draw this diagram again. That is, in one side we have P type semiconductor, or just let me write here P, and on the other side we are having N side semiconductor, and between these two semiconductor there is a junction where charge carriers are depleted, or this region is known as depletion region. So here this is N side, here I am only making the charges on this region as negative and positive, and here I am not showing the ions and free charge carriers. And since we are assuming that this junction is sharp, so I am considering the equal number of free charge carriers in P type and N type. So I am marking this boundary at the middle of this junction. So this is the boundary B. And if we are having a P-type semiconductor with more concentration than N-type, then this boundary will shift into P side. And if the concentration of this N side is more as compared to the P side, then this boundary will move in this direction. So here first let me draw the concentration gradient. So here we can draw the concentration of this region, that we know that after this depletion region in N side there are plenty of electrons, and as we go away from this when the concentration of the electrons will going to decrease. Like this. And we know that there are some electrons also in the p side. So this is the concentration curve for electrons. Similarly, let me write in a different color. That is in p side we are having holes as majority carriers, and as we move from this point there is depletion in the holes, and we also know that we have some holes as minority carriers in the n side. So this red curve is for holes. So this is the concentration gradient, and we can mark this axis as x axis, and on this is y axis, or but here this is concentration. Similarly, we can draw the curve for voltage or potential difference. Here we can see that potential or voltage is increasing as we go from n side to p side. So this is the curve for voltage, here x axis, and here this is the voltage V on the y axis, or here we can write voltage with that is changing with respect to x axis, like this one. So this is the potential, or we can write it as VB or V naught. Let's say it's V naught. So this is the variation of the potential difference across the junction. And similarly, we can draw the variation of the electric field across this junction. Again, this is x axis, and on the y axis it is electric field. And it is important to understand that electric field is shown in the negative y axis. So this is Ex, or variation of the electric field with the x axis. And I am letting this question to you that you have to find out that why we are showing this electric field in the negative direction of the y axis, and it's very important point to note that. So I'm finishing this lecture here. In today's lecture we have discussed about this p-n junction qualitatively, and in the next lecture we will see this junction quantitatively, that is what is the value of this VE and what is the thickness of this depletion region, and how This thickness depends upon the doping concentration and other things. So in next lecture, we will cover all these things.